Okay, it's 12:30 on Sunday, October 15th, and I'm headed out on my dash. I'm going to dash the lunch shift today and the dinner shift. Okay, this first order was an Aldi shop and pay for four items, paying $8.75 to go 3.9 miles. Let's go in and get these items shopped. All right, that was a pretty easy shop. There was only four items in the order, and I found them all relatively quickly. I'm just arriving at the customer to deliver them now. Okay, here's a question for you guys. When you arrive at a house, if there's a table or a chair on the porch, do you put the order on the table or chair versus the ground? I always think it's nicer to put it on a table or a chair. What do you guys do? Okay, this next order was at 7 Friday Sushi, paying $4.92 to go 3.6 miles. It's kind of a weird amount, but I'm here at 7 Friday Sushi to pick it up. Okay, I'm en route to deliver that 7 Friday Sushi order right now. She left very specific instructions saying, do not leave order on porch. Leave in front of garage door.
Arrived.
All right, I delivered that order in front of her garage door as she requested. I then sent her a text to let her know where the order was. Which brings me to my next question. Do you guys keep in contact with your customers throughout the order? I always send them a text when I arrive at the restaurant. I let them know of any delays. I let them know when I'm on my way, and then at the very end when I've delivered their order. What do you guys do? Comment below. All right, this next one's for you, Chuck, with Dashing Across America. My next order I received immediately upon dropping off the last order was at Dollar General to shop for five items. This is one of the reasons I don't like doing Dollar General shops. The aisles are narrow, dark, and there's always clutter blocking them. Also, it's dirty and dusty in there. The shelves are a mess, and the product is always out of stock. All right, surprisingly, I found all the items in that order, and I am on my way to deliver it to the customer right now. Okay, that order is delivered. It was a hand it to me, and he met me outside, so I did not record it. Okay, I'm doing something a little bit different in this video. I'm trying to shorten up my videos, so I'm going to go ahead and recap my first two orders for you, three orders for you. The first one was shopping at Aldi, paying $8.75 for four items. The next order was at 7 Friday Sushi for paying $4.92. That's kind of a weird amount, but it was going 3.6 miles. It wasn't the best order to take, but it was okay. It was still a dollar a mile. And the third item, or the third order, was at Dollar General for five items, paying $10.25 to go 7.6 miles. All three of those are delivered, and I'm on to my next order. Okay, the next two orders were both from Sweetgreen. The first one was paying $9.25 to drive 8.9 miles. I ended up declining that because I just didn't want to go that many miles for $9.25, and I wanted to kind of stick closer to home because I'm coming to the end of this shift. And the next one was paying $3.50-ish or three something at Sweetgreen for 200 feet. Well, I know this is a crap order, but I was right there outside Sweetgreen, and I was 200 feet away from the delivery, so I went ahead and accepted it. Headed into Sweetgreen now to pick up that order. I picked up the order from Sweetgreen, and I literally had to just walk it around the corner to that reserved spot and salon. After delivering that order, I immediately received another garbage order for Sweetgreen, paying $3.50 to go 7.7 miles. That was an absolute decline for me. Okay, I was headed home as my dash was about to end, but on my way home, I received an order from CVS paying $6.25 to go 3.0 miles. I was actually 2 miles away from the store when I received it, so by the time I picked it up, it was less than a mile to delivery.
Turn right onto First Landing Drive, then turn right onto Hernling Drive.
Okay, I'm on my way to deliver that order now.
I'm Hernling.
I'll be back out again tonight for the evening shift. Okay, my first order at the evening shift was at T. James China Cafe, paying $6.25 for a couple of miles. I forgot to screenshot it, but it wasn't any more than like 3 miles. Okay, that order was ready and waiting when I arrived at the restaurant to pick it up. Okay, I delivered that order and now peak pay was starting. So I got my first order at Taste of Asia, paying $12.75 for 5.3 miles. Okay, that order is delivered. Next, I received an order for a local table, paying $8.75 to go 3 miles. I forgot to get the screenshot, so I just inserted the end payout of the order. Immediately after that order, I got an add-on at Local Tables for $8 to go an additional 1.4 miles. I'm here at Local Table now to pick up the orders. Okay, that first delivery is dropped off, and I'm on to my second delivery now. This second delivery was an additional 1.4 miles. As you can see, I have arrived and dropped the order off now. Okay, here's a recap of tonight's orders. My first order was with T. James China Cafe to go 2.5 miles, and it was paying $6.25. The next order I received was when peak pay first started, and it was at Taste of Asia, paying $12.75 to go 5.3 miles. The next order I received was for Local Table, paying $8.75 to go 3 miles. And then after that, they immediately stacked on an $8 order for an additional 1.4 miles at Local Table.